The Global Indian Award being presented to the CEO, Doha Bank Group, Dr. R. Seetharaman. Keep that applause going nice and loud, ladies and gentlemen.
Your Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri K. Rosia, in absentia, Commander Amar Mahadevan, the guest of honor, fellow awardees, distinguished guests, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure and privilege for me to be an integral part of this interesting and important evening. I'm truly humbled by the recognition conferred on me for my own country, for my own state. Thanks to Rotary Club of Madras Metro recognizing this as a global Indian. Today morning I was answering to a set of questions to one of the newspaper editor. I think it's worth sharing their experience. He asked me a first question, being an international economist or a banker. What do you think the current global economic trend is all about? I answered. The second question was confined to recent fiscal cliff deal, how America has disposed and its allied impact. Third one was confined to European economics, then emerging markets. Then he asked me clearly, India is an emerging economy. He moved on to the Gulf states. Then he also was questioning the changing face of the world and the financial markets volatility. And what do I see as a banker, as a practicing banker or economist? What sort of economic momentum we see happening? Then he moved on to the bilateral opportunities between India and the Gulf states. He didn't spare me on the Indian side. Not only India, he asked me, what do you think? You have spent almost 30 years in the Gulf states. How do you see this recognition as a global Indian? What are the changing face of the world which recognize India and Indians? I think if I answer all these questions to you, I've done my job. To put it in perspective, the changing face of the world, the financial crisis, what started in 2008 as a liquidity crisis, has moved to funding crisis. Now it's a sovereign crisis world over. The global growth is still at stake. In concept and substance, the world is very fragile. The IMF dictum predicts, which he attended the meeting in Tokyo a couple of months before, clearly showcase the world is likely to grow between 3.3 to 3.5%. Advanced economies are grossly underperforming. They are delivering not more than 1.5%. Unless we set an universal standard in terms of accounting, valuation, securitization, setting discipline to the execution for the G20, what is once started as G7 or G8 has become G20, we cannot bring in financial stability. That was my answer to him. What we have seen in the financial market is nothing but gambling grounds. By printing money, improving the liquidity, the global supply chain in terms of liquidity has created hard money. It transcended borders and improved the overall momentum in the market space. That's what is a reflection. We have seen 26% growth in India, 29% growth in Germany last year in terms of stock market. Currency market is an absolute trade war. Currency war creates trade war. That's precisely the reason why. currency is weakened in most of the advanced economies. Printing money, quantitative easing, you call it as, is an econometrics by which supply of liquidity will be improved upon, whereby you weaken the currency, import and export dynamics will change. Currency war creates trade wars. That's what America is doing for the fourth time. And again, Japan, the new government, is likely to do. Europe, in its substance and form, is a designer, while monetary policy is centralized, extended the unemployment insurance. And again, in increasing the tax breaks, in making sure the minimum levels have been set to $450,000. That's not going to resolve. Countries and continents who live beyond their means have to pay a price. That's what the lesson we have learned. Whether you run an individual or institution, country or continent, they have to come to terms to live within the means. That's the lessons we have learned. Europe is not, again, out of the problem. It has got a contagion impact. It's not confined to Greece alone. It has moved to Spain. Again, we have seen Italy in troubles. It is not going to be resolved in the next 2 or 3 years. There is a possibility of an abridged version of the Europe as defined by the Maastricht Treaty. Countries who are fulfilling their obligations can live in terms of fiscal prudence, deficit financing, or fiscal consolidation. While emerging markets like India, China, Russia, or Brussels, they have incrementally contributing over 60% of the productivity, they are running a different spell of challenges. India is going through stagflation. The growth is less than the inflation. That results in stagflation. Similar story in terms of Brazil or Russia. India is between 5 to 5.3% is the growth, while inflation is over 7.5%. Result is what we have, the stagflation. We have to consolidate in terms of fiscal prudence. We have to make sure we reduce the current account deficit. We also have to make sure we don't get the sovereign rating down so that your investment grade is not challenged. Your borrowing cost is minimal in international terms. India is liberalizing its frame. It's good opening up the retail. It's good to cut the subsidies. It is good to make sure we have foreign direct inflow by liberalizing the pension or financial sector. Conceptually, it's well-founded, but politics and economics have to converge in real terms to see the world at large is recognizing the opportunity India has emerged. The Gulf states, where I come from, is a trillion-dollar block. In concept, it's 1.6 trillion with 38 million population. Extraordinary momentum in terms of current account surplus, investable surplus, what you call sovereign funds. Bilateral opportunities are there in real substance to see. The logical fitment comes between the Gulf states and India. Not only in terms of proximity or human capital investments, we have opportunity to see that we can bring in trade, investment, banking and finance. That's precisely the reasons why we try to promote the bilateral opportunities. This is the economic face of the world. In concept and substance, if you look at the a bigger picture, the financial stability is not going to come unless we execute, as I said, the universal standards. It's going to take 3 to 4 years. Setting governance which are ensuring sustainability. Making sure, setting norms which are important, not necessarily for social responsibility, to make sure the world at large, the generation to come, is enduring its values for its responsibility. That's what United Nations said. It's not confined to single agenda in the new millennium. It is elimination of extreme poverty, gender equality, and again, making sure we create environment sustainability. That's what I personally focus on. Making sure you institute a culture of green economies so that sustainability comes in. India has to focus in reducing its carbon emissions. There are contentious issues between developed world and developing world which needs to be measured and managed and controlled so that we create a generation which is peaceful. Coming to the last part of my discussion. In concept, India has emerged as a successful combination. 30 years before, when I took my passport, people looked at me with a set of diminution. Today, India is well respected. India has transcended borders. India has moved its econometrics India is consistently getting recognized in terms of global governance. No question about it. Indians have transcended every part of the world. Go to America or Australia, you see Indians are performing. Whichever be the country, whichever be the profession they're engaged in, they are adding values. Hardworking, committed, responsible, social citizenship. That's the recognition we had as Indians. We are proud to be Indian as a fraternity. Time has come to reverse your citizenship back in track even for persons of Indian origins. That's the momentum we are seeing. There are people who have done it. I haven't changed my passport. There was no necessity for me. I believed in India. I still believe. My generations to come will believe. We are proud of our heritage or culture or values. There's no question about it. Look at the Indian cinema. I'm a great fan of Shivaji Ganesh. I was in Russia last week, myself and my wife, we were together in Moscow University. At the invitation of the Tamil wing, I was there. I was taken back on the incidents which I have gone through. Wherever I go, to characterize myself, I used to narrate the Tamil version of Shivaji Ganesan, the Ilakkiya Tamil. I was surprised when we were contemplating options on Silapanigaram and Manimekhalai or Tolhapiyam, and we moved to Shivaji Ganesan subjects. The chief of the Tamil wing, Mr. Alexander, Mr. Sampath knows, Ms. A.R. Lakshman knows, he brought with so much passion about Shivaji Ganesan, and he started talking about Veeravandiya Kattabomman. I did Veeravandiya Kattabomman character, and he did Jakshan Durai. And again, we moved on to Parasakti, we moved on to Manohara. Then the final part came when I was trying to showcase Shivaji Ganesan and his character and substance as Shivabhiraman in Shanbaha Pandian. And we were on fire with each other. And I was surprised how India has transcended, Tamil has transcended, how our culture has transcended, our literature has transcended, how our acting as a character of embodiment today, Shivaji Ganesan still lives in form and substance every part of the world. That's a simple example, I say. When I started putting, he was reacting spontaneously. He's talking a Russian talking in substance. Alexis, I was taken aback when he was brought in Nakira. Parudulla Bata in the Val, Parzuk, Arhadele in the Reddit to Kuriavan Nantan, Yan the Kerman. தமிழ்ச்சங்கத்தின் தலைமை காவலர் நக்கீரனா தமிழ்ச்சங்கத்தின் தலைமை காவலர் அளவத்தினால் தான் என் பாட்டியை குற்றம் கண்டீரா என்ன குற்றம் கண்டீர் முதற்கட் பாட்டை எழுதியது யார் யாம் யாம் எத்திரோம் எழுதிய தாங்கள் வராமல் புலவன் துருமியிடம் கொடுத்தனுப்ப வேண்டிய காரணம் இப்படி பேச்சுனே போலாம் ஒரு 3 மணி நேரம் I lost myself. Trust me, I lost myself. Then we went to, as a guest of honor, I was invited for the Diwali Mela last month. Every single state of India was characterized. The dance forms, while Indian children were showing Shakuntalam, Raghuvamsam, Kumarasambhavam, I saw every single state dance form, Kuchipudi, Kathakali, Manipuri, Bharatanatyam, every single dance form was showcased by Russian boys and girls. You tell me, where is global Indian today? Where is Indian cinema today? Indian cinema, whether it is Bollywood or Kollywood or Tollywood, Telugu is very famous in United States. We are seeing the transition in true form and substance. Indian food has moved everywhere. It is ITC, it is Taj, and again, chain of restaurants world over. Sarana Bhavan to Anjapur now. Even in Doha, we have, in the Gulf states, predominantly, vegetarianism is transgressing. That's the level of change we have seen. It's dance. It is, again, Indian festival. I have virtually celebrated every part of the world. Every single part of the world, Diwali. Pongal I have celebrated, you know it. Whether it is Malaysia or Singapore or United States, we have done it. You want to celebrate Holi, you go to Canada or London. You want to see the Tamil literature, you can hear in every part of the world. That's the kind of change we are seeing in India. Around the world, Indian form of substance, our heritage, our culture, our language has penetrated world over. We are dispersed. We are proud of being Indians. And we are clearly seeing how it disperses around the world. We don't feel alone. Our value system relish around the world. Our culture has transcended borders. Our character and commitment is also adding value to the global enterprise. That's the level of change we are seeing. We are committed to make sure we are responsible, not only for creating better India, better citizenship, we also have to necessarily recognize that we create a better world and better citizens to make sure the world is peace and prosperous. I once again thank the Rotary Club Madras Metro for recognizing me personally, and I am continue to commit myself for the United Nations missions in sustaining the environment and knowledge society. Me and my family are delighted to be an integral part of this interesting and exciting evening. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your attention.